check before I start moving again. There's the back of my car in the back passenger window. Start turning, looking out for the door handle to touch the curb. And guys, this is just the technique that I teach my students. It works well for me, it works well on my car. Don't put that in. What is up, guys? It's Francis, the instructor, and here we are with TDS TV at Mitcham Test Centre, Red House Road. If you're taking your driving test in Mitcham, this is going to be a super useful video for you. I'm going to walk you and talk you through one of the Mitcham driving test routes. I've got it plugged into my sat nav right now. I'm going to drive through, commentating and telling you what's going on the driving test. Here we are, Mitcham Test Centre. So let's start as normal. I am going to take a position in one of the bays and then we'll make a start. Would you like an explanation of how the test works? You'll say yes, and they'll say something along the lines of, okay, sure, the driving test is gonna last 38 to 40 minutes. We're gonna complete one maneuver and potentially an emergency stop. We are going to follow independent driving for 20 minutes, either following a sat nav or following road signs. And if I'm directing you, all I want you to do is follow the road ahead, obey all road signs. And if I want you to turn left or right, I'll let you know. Make sense? Yeah, thanks. Okay, great. So next, start the engine and drive on when you're ready. All right, so I've got the route plugged into the sat nav. Starting point. Let's wait for the traffic to clear. There's one of the driving tests coming up. Coming back from their test, hopefully they've passed. Do you know what? Let's not wait for the traffic. I know how to drive. Checking all around. Good observation is key. And we'll make a move. So important to note that the slip road here that's leading you up to the main road is not 10 miles an hour. There's a 10 mile an hour sign back there, but this is the normal road speed. Think about the appropriate speed. It's quite narrow. There's stuff going on at the end, so you want to take it at a decent speed, but not 10 miles an hour, because that'll make you look hesitant and like you don't know what you're doing. We're turning right around the security entrance. Remember, you need to move back to the left nice and quickly. If someone else is coming down the slip road, entering Croydon Mitcham Test Centre as well, you need to move out of their way because they've got priority, the hazard's on your side. Okay, so we're on the main road. First 5 minutes of your driving test, you might feel a little bit nervous. If you feel nervous, that's okay. That's very normal. All you need to do is keep planning ahead and anticipating. What's next? How am I going to deal with it? That's all that's going through your head. What is next? How am I going to deal with it? Keep planning and anticipating so you don't even have time to think about, I'm on a driving test. So we're planning ahead. What can we see? Big, massive skip lorry. I can't see past it, so that's why I'm keeping such a massive distance. The further back I am, the more I can see around that skip lorry. I'm not going too fast. Decent speed for this road. There's lots of hazards. Parked cars can't really see the pavements too well. Okay, where am I going next? Always keeping an eye on that sat nav. I know I'm turning left in 270 yards. So I'm gonna start to get ready for that. I'm even anticipating before the sat nav tells me where I'm going.
After 200 yards, turn left, then turn right.
Not stopping too close to the skip lorry. This road does quite often have a bit of traffic on it. If you're in traffic, great. Gives you more time to relax and chill. Make sure that you keep the distance between you and the vehicle in front, because that takes the pressure off. If I'm super close to that car or van or lorry, it's putting me under more pressure because I've got to be more accurate with my clutch and brake. Keeping it clear for the cemetery. Now moving on. Not rushing, taking it nice and easy. I'm not speeding up too much because I know that we're in traffic. What's the point smashing on the gas so that I have to then brake super hard? I can see what the sat nav's telling me, so I know how quickly I'm approaching that corner. Now I'm translating what I see on the sat nav to what I can see in real life. There's the junction. Checking my mirrors. Signal.
Left, then turn
right. Did I say right? I mean left. I think I said right, didn't I? Okay. Nice and smooth around the corner. No need to rush this at all. Checking my mirror before I move out. No, signal. This is a really dense street. The parked cars are super close to me, so I didn't rush that corner at all. What if there was a car coming down this road? How would I have dealt with that in time if I was whizzing around that corner in second gear, 15 miles an hour? That's not an appropriate speed. So planning ahead, I can see a crossroads. Who's got priority? Planning that in advance. Is it me? It is. The other cars have give way lines. Now, we're in a meeting situation. I don't know what this car's gonna do. I could have maybe taken a chance and followed through the gap and hope that they give me priority. But remember, priority is something that you can't take, something you can only give. So I took control of the situation by giving that lady priority. She went round and we're all good. We don't want to be driving aggressively road, on your driving test. Left. Turning left at the end. All right, so 150 yards away. Not appropriate to signal now, and I can see it's just after this bend because I'm looking at the sat-nav. What else am I looking at? 30 mile an hour speed limit sign, and it seems to be some roadworks. Signaling left and turning left. Remember, turn left. If you pull your steering wheel back, the signal cancels. So remember to put it back on again. And I'm not rushing this. Now we're in traffic again. Quite often, if you're in Mitcham or Croydon Driving Test Centre, there is a lot of traffic in the area. So just relax. Take it nice and easy, keep a nice big gap between yourself and the vehicle in front. How relaxed do I feel being this far back? If the car in front does something weird, I've got enough time to think, process it and react. Always checking my mirrors, even if it's just the smallest change of direction that I'm taking on the road. Why? There could be a motorbike or a cyclist overtaking or undertaking. Island in the middle of the road, I didn't stop for that pedestrian because it's not a crossing. Maybe, if you're driving in real life after your driving test, it might be nice to stop for pedestrians if you've got the opportunity and it's not confusing the vehicles behind you. But on my driving test, I'm going to drive black and white. I know the rules and I'm going to demonstrate the rules. So I know that if there's an island, I'm not necessarily stopping for pedestrians. Just trying to work out what those police were doing. Interesting. Shall we loop back round later and find out?
After 300 yards, cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Alrighty then. So I'm gonna relax there. Tires on tarmac to the car in front. Not stopping too close to it. Keeping my distance, my safety bubble. You can't see, but I can see the car behind is super close to me, probably about that close. If I then stop too close to the car in front, I'm just in a car sandwich. I can't do anything. I can't move back. I can't move forward. Compromising your safety bubble is not okay. Make sure that even if the car behind is too close to you, you don't then try and nudge forward, because if that's their stopping distance, they're going to get closer to you anyway and probably just nudge forward and you nudge forward. Let's deal with this roundabout. Central London.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
Even though I'm using a sat-nav, I'm still looking at the road signs because that's going to show me a much clearer picture potentially than the sat-nav does. So she said second exit. She's calling it a roundabout. The sign called it a roundabout. It doesn't look much like a roundabout, but I'm going to treat it like one. So, not signaling now, but once I pass the first exit, it's just a little junction, so don't miss it. I'm going to signal left. Even though really, doesn't look much like you need to. So here's the little turning that she's calling a first exit. Signaling.
Take the exit.
And leaving. Not super necessary to signal because there's nowhere else I can go from this lane. Remember, don't sit stationary on cycle boxes or pedestrian crossings. That's super important. And keeping a good distance between me and the vehicle in front. Checking mirrors before I move off. Why is that important? Who could be in my left or right mirror? What's this pedestrian doing? He's definitely approaching the crossing. So I'm anticipating well, not slowing down. Not slowing down? Definitely slowing down. Not speeding up too fast. All right, let's crack on. 30 miles an hour on this road. Let's do an assessment of the practical speed. Is it safe to do 30? I'm doing 30 right now. Well, 29. Feel safe. There's a minimal amount of hazards. I've got my eye on the pedestrians on the pavement. There's no parked cars blocking my vision. There's lots of islands, so I've got a great view of the pedestrians crossing, and the traffic on the other side of the road is not that close to me.
After 400 yards, turn right.
I'm keeping up with the traffic ahead of me. I'm not creating too much gap between me and the car in front. What's that going to do? That's going to encourage cars to jump out and fill that gap. Then I've got to do more thinking and slow down. Right, in 100, 200, what did she say? It's really a common mistake to miss what the sat-nav says. Remember, she's going to repeat it, but you can always ask. Ask your examiner for directions. They will always help you with directions, unless it's super obvious. If it's super obvious and the sign's right in front of you, they might just say, read the sign. But remember to always ask if you need help with directions. All right, so this is a yellow box. Common mistake is not sitting in the yellow box. I'm going to give that bus some room, but then I'm going to move forward right to my point of turn, sit dead on the middle of the yellow box, and then wait for a gap in traffic, which is after this white car. Why am I sitting on the yellow box? Is that allowed? Yes, because I'm turning right and my exit is clear. Really essential. Make sure that the examiner knows you know that rule by demonstrating it. How do you demonstrate? Just sit on the box. Enter the box, go into the box, even if you don't need to. Right, okay, cool. It's the same with mirror checks, guys. Listen, you might be able to get away with checking the mirrors like that. Can you see my eyes moving? Barely. Same with the examiner. He can barely see your eyes moving, or she. Make sure that you're, yeah, look, I'm playing the game, ticking all the boxes.
At the end of the road, turn left. Then, at the end of the road, turn left.
Got it. The driving test is just a tick box exercise. If you tick all the boxes and prove that you're safe, you'll get a driving license. So make sure they know that you're checking all the mirrors. Don't try and side cut your eyes or whatever. Make sure that you're checking properly.
Turn left. Then, at the end of the road, turn left.
All right, roger that. Checking, checking. Do I need to stop at all giveaway lines? Nope. If I can safely slow down enough and see that there's nothing coming, I do not need to stop at the giveaway line. Let's pull over on the left in a safe place. The examiner on your driving test is going to ask you to do this 5 or 6 times. Sometimes they'll just say, pull up on the left in a safe place, now drive on again. What they're doing is they're testing how well you park on the left and whether you know where it is legal to park. So that's no yellow lines, no red lines, and no dropped curbs. All those three things are where you can't legally park in real life. The examiner might say, pull up on the left behind the black Mercedes van. If there's a drop curb, ask, can I park on that drop curb? Do you want me to park on that drop curb? Usually they'll say, pull up on the left, ignore the driveways on this occasion, or ignore the yellow line on this occasion if they want you to park in a specific place. But if they ask you to pull up on the left in a safe place, remember, don't park across drop curbs, yellow lines or red lines. Next, I'd like you to move off when you're ready. Okay. Prepare. Serve. Signal. Handbrake. Checking my blind spot twice. And turning left. Car coming on the right. I was going slow enough so that they signaled really late. I was going slow enough so that if there was a car coming, I'd be able to stop for it smoothly. If there's no car coming, I'll be able to carry on and make a safe decision.
After 200 yards, turn right.
Alrighty then. After 200 yards, turn right. 200 yards at 20 miles an hour, which is the speed limit around here, hope you guys caught it, is quite a long way.
Turn right.
Mirror, signal. Signaling soon enough that everyone knows what I'm doing and has enough time to react, but not signaling too early that it looks like I'm parking. Okay, junction coming up. I can see that this is a crossroads and I don't have priority, so I'm slowing down first gear straight away.
After 100 yards, turn left.
So that I can crawl up to the junction and not have to stop if there's nothing coming. Perfect! Give yourself these little wins when you're on your driving test. If you do something well, tell yourself.
Turn left.
No problemo. Perfect junction again. I'm telling myself that I've got that right. on your driving lessons, your instructor's gonna tell you, well done, that was amazing. On your driving test, the examiner's gonna keep really quiet. You're gonna doubt yourself. Get used to telling yourself when you do stuff.
Turn left, then take the second right.
Got it. Get used to telling yourself when you do stuff really well. When you do stuff right,
turn
give yourself
left,
a boost.
Then take the second right.
Okay, turn left. After this motorbike, there's a nice gap. It's not a massive gap, but I know that I can get my car out safely. How do I know that? I'm asking myself, would I cross the road in that space? If I would cross the road, then I'd definitely be able to drive across because I can drive quicker than I can walk. So that's a really good test. Would you walk across the road in that gap? If yes, you would drive across. Trying really hard there not to cut the corner. I didn't want to not take that opportunity where the lights were red, but I also don't want to cut the corner. So I took that really slowly and made sure my steering was super accurate. That's important.
After 200 yards, bear right.
No problem. Bear right. So let's listen to that one. She said bear right. That could be a misleading information. So I'm going to take what I can see on the screen, what she's telling me, and try and decipher what that is actually doing on the road. Okay, so here's the turning.
Right.
I can see because I'm only 30 yards away. Signal, check in the mirror a couple of times, and turn. And then checking, making sure that there's nothing coming. Even though, yes, I've got priority here, I've got L plates on. On the top of the car, there's a driving school and L plates, which means that people are very likely to not give you priority when you're due it. I tell you what, let's pull up on the left and ignore the driveways on this occasion. And relax. When you pull up on a hill, especially one this big, that steep, make sure you've got the handbrake on enough. I know it's a really common mistake to, okay, just give the handbrake two clicks, relax, and then the car's rolling back, it's actually rolling backwards just a tiny bit, but it starts off just a tiny bit, so you don't realise. And then, as it starts to build up, and you realise when you're at about 2-3 miles an hour, you're already in the car behind, in their bonnet. So, next, drive on when you're ready. No problem, because it's a hill start, I'm going to take my time. Some people like to do it with a handbrake, that's great. I can get my biting point, set the gas, signal, handbrake. Some people like to do it with the brake, that's no problem. You can take the brake off now if you want to. Signal, handbrake, and drive on. Personal preference, 100% up to you, or up to whatever your instructor teaches you. Both methods are perfectly fine.
After 80 yards, sharp left.
No problem, sharp left, nice one. Thanks for that warning. So I'm gonna slow right down, make sure that my steering is enough for that corner.
After 100 yards, bear right.
Bear right. Bear right. Is it a continuation of the road? Yes, it is. I'm looking at the center lines of the road. Super confusing, these sat navs. Watching out for the fox. Super confusing, yes, but if you practice it enough on these TomTom 52s, you'll be used to hearing the word bear and thinking, okay, I need to look at the road markings here because it might not be what I think it is. Practice. The only thing, the biggest advice really on all the videos is practice a lot, as much as you can. Watch as many videos as you can. Immerse yourself in driving. And by the time you take your test, you'll be so confident that it'll just be procedure, a tick box exercise. It'll just be a confirmation of your driving excellence. All right, still 20 miles an hour speed limit, taking it nice and easy. What's happening ahead? I'm always thinking about what could be next. If a car comes down the road towards me, I'm gonna know where I can pull over behind the Aygo, and they're gonna pull over or slightly move to the right in front of that VW.
Turn
right, then left. She's given me two instructions in one because the junctions are close together. So I can start to plan ahead.
Turn left.
Thank you. Okay. Pull up on the left in a safe place. All right, little bit of a weird one here. If you see a disabled bay, I would ask, do you want me to park? Is the disabled bay okay? Yes, right, this is a disabled bay, it's fine. We're not actually parking for very long. All I want you to do next is move off from here and reverse park back into this position. Ooh, evil one. So she's given me, he's given me, the examiner's given me a parallel park, and it's quite a busy road. What I don't want to do is set off on this road and stop again next to that dark blue aquamarine turquoise. What the colour is that? Turquoise Golf. Don't want to do that, because then the car vehicle behind me, even though that van that's coming, which you guys can't see, is quite a long way down the road. If I set off and stop, that's the last thing that they're expecting. They're going to expect me to set off and start moving down the road. So if I set off and stop in about 2 meters, 3 meters, it's going to be unexpected. They'll stop right behind me and wreck my maneuver. So there it is. Gonna try and get this done nice and quick because it's a busy road. I'm looking out at all of the vehicles behind me. I can see there's one there. I'm not gonna start turning left, because as soon as I start turning left, my vehicle moves, the front of it moves out to the right, which creates less gap for the cars that are behind me to get past. And I don't want an audience. I don't want an audience on my driving test. So give them enough room to move around, taking a nice good check before I move off again. And there's the back of the car in the back passenger window, taking one nice brisk but smooth turn to the left, looking out for my door handle to touch the curb, keeping up the good observation all the way around and making sure that I keep the car speed low as well. There it is, and we are parked. Handbrake neutral. Next, the examiner is going to say thanks very much, move on. If they say something like, are you happy with that? Don't say yes, because they're giving you a lifeline. Or something like, are you done? Are you finished? No, you're not finished. Find the mistake. It's either something like, you haven't straightened up your wheels, or handbrake neutral, or find the mistake. It's not going to be something massive and glaring. If you've got the opportunity to rescue it a little bit, or maybe you're just too far from the curb, it's not going to be something like you need to start again. Don't start moving around and starting again. If they give you that little lifeline, just maybe check the wheels are straight. Check that you've got your indicator in the right place, handbrake neutral's done, and I'm close enough to the curb. They won't let you drive off and say, thanks, drive on, if there's something that you can easily fix well, if you get a nice examiner on a good day. So let's carry on. Maneuver over, now you can relax. The rest of it is just driving. You've nailed it.
After 200 yards, cross the roundabout and take the first exit.
Yes. No problem. Cross the roundabout and take the first exit. So where's the roundabout? There's the blue sign. We can see that just through the trees.
Cross the roundabout and take the first exit.
How do you approach a roundabout? Fast, slow, with caution. This one is quite a built-up area, so I'm going to approach it a lot more slowly than if I was in, say, a wide, busy area. Now remember, drive to the conditions of the road. Those girls that were crossing the road, should they have crossed the road there? Should I have let them cross the road? No, I didn't let them cross the road. They gave me no option to stop. So I wasn't being hesitant, I was being cautious and not trying to run people over, because that's not going to work well on your driving test. So if you see someone trying to cross the road, should you let them go? No. If they give you no option, then you have to. Right, so what's next? How am I going to deal with it? Speed bumps. Parked cars on the left, blocking my view of the pavements. How am I going to deal with it? Just keeping my speed low. Coming off the gas before I get to the bump so that it's nice and glidy over the bump. Just like that. Ooh, smooth like butter. Speed limit still 20. There's a reminder on the floor in case you didn't know. Look at that behind the van though. We can't see anything that's happening on that approach to that island. What could be around there? Anyone. Pedestrians, road workers, cats, dogs, foxes, like we saw earlier. So we're going to approach stuff like that cautiously. Be ready to stop. Are we going to let the pedestrian go? No, but I'm going to be ready to stop if she gives me no option. That's important. behind this van, there could be anything again. I'm going to be cautious. I'm not going to react until there's something to react to, but I'm going to keep my speed at a level where if someone was to walk out from behind, I don't have enough speed that I can't do anything about it, basically. Abandoned car. I can tell now that we're coming back towards the test center. I can feel it because I've been practicing in the area. Well, I know the area very well, but if you've been practicing in the area around Mitcham, you'll know that you're coming back to the test area, to the test center, right about now. Oh, I swear it's only one roundabout, one right turn and one left turn back to the test center. Yes, you're right.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit, then turn right.
It's only about three corners to the Wait, stop. Because now you're thinking about coming back to the test center and the mistakes that you've made and whether you've passed or failed yet. And you're not concentrating.
And take the first exit.
You need to keep focused all the way till the end of your driving test until the examiner tells you that your exam is over. So don't start just switching off and...
You have reached your destination.
Thanks. Don't start switching off and thinking about what could be your driving license winging its way into the post towards your house. Stop. Because if you start switching off and thinking about daydreaming, you will fail your driving test. So we're going to keep alert. This road has no repeater signs on it. What's the speed limit?
After 200 yards, you have reached your destination.
20 miles an hour. And yeah, you could easily have this as a 30 mile an hour speed limit zone. There's no pedestrians, it's not even residential, but if that's the mandated speed limit, you must keep to it. So important. You could do what you want after your driving test, not really, but on your driving test, make sure that you follow the rules rigidly. So important. Okay, now the sat-nav's told me I've reached my destination. The examiner will tell you, thanks, that's the end of independent driving. I'll direct you from here. The examiner is going to give you verbal commands. So, turning left at the traffic lights. No problem, Mr. Examiner. I got this. Watch. Spotted the 30 sign. Mirror. A couple of mirror checks. Prove that I know that it's 30 miles an hour because I can't tell him. He's not going to ask me either. So I'm proving that I know that it's 30 by going at 30, or the appropriate speed for this road, which probably could be more than 30, but that's the mandated speed limit, so we're gonna stick to it. This road used to be 40 miles an hour. If you took your test back in the day, you would know that, or if you've been learning for that long, you would also know that. Make sure that you keep to 30 like I'm doing. Oh, we're nearly at the test center. Stop. Your mind's drifting again. Back on target. What's happening next? What are you going to do about it? So, you know that the examiner's next going to tell you to turn right. But, pedestrian, even if you can't find anything to anticipate or plan about, keep looking. You will find something when it's safe to do so. Demist your rear windscreen. All right, cool. Bang, bang, done. Drive on. Mirror, signal, position. Onto the hatch area so that I'm neat and out of the way. Speed, looking to the right, little wave to the security. You don't have to do that on your driving test. The examiner will give them a little wave. If he's in a good mood and you haven't given him whiplash on your driving test. Okay, so here, we've had no speed limit signs. Remember that this is the speed limit of the road before. I would recommend about 15 to 17 miles an hour for this stretch of road. And then once you pass the driving test center, this is where it turns into 10 miles an hour. So next, let's go and park up. And let's get the result of the driving test. Okay, Francis, if you'd like to secure the car, switch off, and give me a second to tot up my results. All right, no problem, Mr. Examiner. Francis, I'm pleased to tell you that you've passed. Well done. Your driving license is going to come in the post. Awesome. So, guys, that's Mitcham Test Centre. Hopefully you learned something from that. If I made any mistakes, if you spotted me making any minors, comment below. I'll debate them with you in the comment section. Until the next one, I'm Francis, the instructor for TDS TV. See you in the next video.